say Islam and or Hebrewism. I've heard people say that the Kemetic Mysteries and or Akhenaten's monotheism was the first culture. Well, me and Dr. Ben disagree. Kemet and Kush's cultures are the greatest representation of a culture deeper and older than in Africa, or Afro-Rica, which was the word that was used to denote inner Africa, as stated by Gerald Massey and Ivan Van Cernimer. And as for any claims that people make about having the oldest and purest known culture on Earth, if your claim don't match with the facts, proof, and evidence that is actual and tangible, then your claim is unsubstantiated mythology. Scholarship is based upon supplying tangible and scrutinized evidence to support any claim made. If you claim in a culture that can't stretch back beyond 5-10,000 years ago on a planet that we are proven to have been on for eons, then you cannot academically prove it is the oldest. Especially not after I show you the oldest proof that's been found that we have the oldest culture on the planet. There was found in inner Africa a 70 to 100,000 year old voodoo ceremonial site. They found the ceremonial items, such as red ochre that dates back to 77,000 years ago. They found the patterns in ancient glyphs on 55,000 year old ostrich eggs and 13 additional items and such dating back to 75,000 years ago to 100,000 years ago. Before this find, Europeans said that the oldest sign of culture was a 40,000-year-old ceremonial site that was in Europe. But like everybody else who makes unfounded claims, they were proven wrong. And Dr. Ben also explained this in his book, African Origins of the Major African Religions. On his first few pages of his book, he explains that the African traditional religions preceded every religion, including the ancient Egyptian mysteries and the Kushite mysteries. He even implied that the Kemetic and Kushite mysteries are merely the Kushite and Egyptian form of that traditional African culture that they found 70,000 years ago, i.e. Kushite and Kemetic voodoo. Now, don't get the voodoo thing all wrong. A cursory African language study reveals that voodoo means introspection into the mystery. Vu, introspection, and do, into mystery. That's where the term voodoo comes from. In other words, we say the Egyptian mystery schools, but the ancients called it Kemetic voodoo. The term mystery system comes from the word voodoo. And if you read about Yoruba and voodoo in the Kemetic and Kushite culture, you'll notice that they are exactly the same thing as West African voodoo today, except that the voodoo culture has the Kemetic gods in their pantheon, but the Kemet mysteries only have gods from North and East Africa. The Kushite mysteries and Kemetic mysteries both stem from, as Dr. Ben stated, the older mysteries of inner Africa, voodoo and Yoruba, also known as the African traditional religions. Dr. Shenkata Tia, among others, explained that the Yoruba and the Dogon were the priests of Kush and Kemet. And Dr. Shenkata Tia, among others, explained that the Yoruba and the Dogon were the priests of Kemet and Kush who went to the west when Kemet was being overrun. These cultures are all the same. Ancestral veneration, honoring the gods, gaining psychic abilities, magic, and ultimately turning you back into a god. This was the culture most of us came to this country with. Either we were voodoo or people. This was the culture most of us came to this country with. Either we were voodoo people or we were Muslim. And those of us that were Muslim were tortured into it during the Moroccan invasion of West Africa in 1591. But before then, every African nation had their own form of voodoo that only differed in which African gods were most popular in whatever areas. Even if you watch Shaka Zulu, you'll see the same culture in the 1800s before the Zulu went down. And if you look around at the pre-religious world, you see these same ancient African traditions everywhere. The culture of the China, same thing. Africa, same thing. India, same thing. The indigenous traditions of every land is filled with what the Africans call voodoo. The Kushites call their culture the ancient solar rite of the great invisibles of Ethiopia. The ancients also referred to their traditional culture as the solar rite of the sun. But the term that's come down to us, hidden in the Western term mystery school, is voodoo. To quote Dr. Bibb, and this is actually in his preface, the traditional religions of the indigenous African peoples and their descendants, which are notoriously called paganism and fetishism by antagonists of the so-called Western religions, are in fact the forerunners of the now Bali religions. Therefore, they are the creators of the mysteries of Sais, Egypt, Kush, Ethiopia, and Nubia Sedan. This is shown in the text of this volume, along with the fact that the mysteries were developed from the ancient religious rites of the indigenous Africans who once occupied the lands around the major Great Lakes of Central Africa and along the headwaters of the Nile River. Just to repeat, the traditional religions of the indigenous African peoples and their descendants, which are notoriously called paganism, are in fact the forerunners of now Bali religions. Therefore, they are the creators of the mysteries of Egypt, Kush, Ethiopia, Nubia, Sudan. And to quote Dr. Ben a little further in his book, African Origins of the Major Western Religions, he says the similarity between existing religious practices in parts of West, Central, East, and South Africa with that of the ancient indigenous Africans of Egypt is not coincidental, but instead is common to the heritage which began along the Great Lakes of Central Africa and the headwaters of the Nile River, as shown in this work. The whole rest of his book is proving, you know, my point and his point, you know, fact that all cultures, including the Nile Valley cultures, descend from the traditional African religions that they call paganism today. The words paganism, fetishism, shamanism, and voodoo are all interchangeable words. They all basically mean the same exact thing. And that's what we was doing eons ago. And that's what many of us still do today. To quote Dr. Shenkata Diop, in his book, African Origin of Civilization, where he, a chapter called The Egyptian Origin of the Yoruba, where he's explaining how the Yoruba, you know, are the direct descendants from the ancient Egyptians. He shows that they have the same gods. These are some of the gods in the Yoruba tribe. Osiris, Isis, Horus, Shu, Sut, Thoth, Kepera, Amun, Anu, Khonsu, Khnum, Khopri, Hathor, Sokars, Ra, Seb, the four elemental deities, and others. Their language had the same words in it, you know, period. And Yoruba, where they live at in West Africa, their culture is the exact same as everybody else's. Voodoo and Yoruba could also be used interchangeably. They even have most of the same gods in their pantheon. And that's always the only difference between the different geographical tribes of Africa and the form of spirituality, the form of voodoo that they observe. The only difference is ever which gods are more popular in whatever areas. But to quote Dr. Shenkata Diop, he quotes a guy named J. Olamide Lucas, who traces the Egyptian origin of known as ancient Egypt